Good evening. This is Devin Tracy reporting to you live from Philadelphia, the Democratic National Convention. Breaking news story, we have a bunch of sour, bitter, salty, juvenile little bitches who are trying to rage quit from politics and throw the Monopoly board up in the air by booing Hillary Clinton.
We wanted Bernie.
Scumbaggery on full display. It's a total abortion of their own principles. They don't know what the fuck they're doing, and they're revealing their immaturity and palpable retardation with every boo. Fuck you people, and let me be the first to say, as a Hillary supporter, suck my Hillary supporting dong, you fucking weaklings. But be my guest, shit the bed and give the country over to Trump and be on the wrong side of history. None of you people are acting like adults, and quite frankly, it's not shocking because you are not adults. The President of the United States needs to be qualified, experienced, sensible, and mature. She doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to agree on your favorite ice cream flavor. She's not going to be as non-politically correct as you would like her to be, because guess what? She's a politician. And guess what politicians do? They say shit that's politically correct. It's kind of the origin of the phrase. So spare me the fucking, oh, she's not perfect, she said this, she tweeted that. Eat a fucking sandwich of dicks. So tired of you people. And by the way, this stat that these Bernie dipshits trot out, it's so priceless, where they say, hey, Bernie against Trump does better than Hillary against Trump, so why didn't we elect Bernie? The reason for that is because the Hillary supporters, when asked, would you vote for Trump or Bernie, are sane and adult and would be like, yeah, well, I'm not really big into Bernie, but against Trump, yeah, I'm voting for Bernie. It's the Bernie or bust bitches who say, no, Bernie or nothing, fuck it. No Hillary, never Hillary, screw her. I'm just gonna fester in my own bitterness and let the country burn, screw it. Now, all of these people should listen to Sarah Silverman, who is a Bernie supporter, but who is also sane, apparently.
As I continue to be inspired and moved to action by the ideals set forth by Bernie, who will never stop fighting for us, I am proud to be a part of Bernie's movement. And a vital part of that movement is making absolutely sure that Hillary Clinton is our next president of the United States. Booyah, baba booey. The Bernie, can I just say, to the Bernie or bust people, you're being ridiculous.
Now, one of the people who fall into this camp of, I didn't get my way, bleh, okay, is a man named Jimmy Dore.
There's nothing worse than the Crusades. There's nothing worse than dropping nuclear bombs. There's nothing worse than the Crusades. There's nothing worse than dropping nuclear bombs. There's nothing worse than the Crusades. There's nothing worse than dropping nuclear bombs.
Who should be fired right now is not fired, and let that sink in. He's just coming off spitting on a man. He should be put in jail for this. He has not been. He's currently covering the Democratic Convention. But I want you to just sit with a moment that happened last week on the Young Turks. However, they decided not to upload this video. I wonder why not. I'll tell you why not. It's because it's embarrassing. It's a revealing insight into the nature of these human beings. And it makes them look like angry amateur hack jobs, which they are. In this conversation, Ben Mankiewicz is basically saying to Jimmy Dore, it's time to get real. Your candidate lost? Bernie? In fact, that was Ben's candidate. He wanted Bernie. But now he's obviously voting for Hillary, because if you are on the left, if you are even remotely Democratic, and you have a two-person race between a Republican, psycho, egomaniacal
pap smear,
and Hillary Clinton, the most overqualified candidate for president ever, then the choice is clear and obvious. But Jimmy Dore is not going to vote for Hillary Clinton. Nah. He wants to let the country burn, give it over to the other guys, and then try again 4 years later. That's his plan. Let's watch how this encounter goes down.
Let me just say real quick on that point. He doesn't have the ability to do that. Right now, the Republicans won't even give Merrick Garland a meeting for a year without batting an eye. So why wouldn't the Democrats be able to do the same thing for 2 years?
They should.
And if we keep voting for weak sauce, we're going to keep getting more of it.
If you don't vote for Hillary Clinton and we end up with Donald Trump, you're going to bear a bit of responsibility
for the...
No, it's her fault for not coming and getting my vote.
No,
I want to vote for her.
Vote for her.
No, no,
then bite the bullet and vote for her.
Yes, it is the grown-up thing to do. Here's what's not a grown-up thing to do. Spit on a man's face and then scurry away. This reminds me of what I used to do when I was a kid. I played Ding Dong Ditch. Anybody out there know that game? You ding and then you dong. And what that means is you sneak up to somebody's house, you press the doorbell, and it goes ding dong, and then you run away, you ditch. Okay, that was it. That's the game. How fun is that? It's awesome. But then I turned 10. Jimmy, first of all, a subscriber of mine left one of the best comments ever. He said, "Why does Jimmy Dore dress like an 8-year-old boy on his way to his aunt's wedding?" It's so true. So true. And it's probably because he's some sort of broken comedian, desperate for validation, sort of addicted to coke, all sorts of darkness within him. He's a child. I mean, it's one thing to be an idealistic, naive college student Bernie supporter. You're just dumb. Your brain hasn't developed. You haven't even lived a goddamn life to know how dumb and stupid you are. But if you're an old Bernie supporter, oh, fucking hell, fuck you. And by the way, you don't like this? You don't like that I like Hillary Clinton? Here's what you don't like. You don't like the cognitive dissonance that guys like me and Sam Harris are obviously voting for Hillary Clinton. It's not even a fucking choice. And you agree with us on 99% of shit, except for this, your blind spot. And yes, I know Hillary's not the sexy choice. I know she's not sexy at anything. In the 70s, she was. I would bang her from behind in the 70s. I'd bang her front ways. She was cute as hell. The point is, we're not nominating somebody to give us a full body massage. We are nominating a qualified adult to take a very difficult job on. The presidency does not define you. Okay, you can go out and do whatever you want. Express yourself. Create a Pinterest page and just tell me all about you. This is your favorite movie. This is your favorite music. The president of the United States is not a referendum on who you are personally. Okay, let's try to avoid the disastrous decision of Donald Trump. Please, can we just get that done? Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do to not elect Donald Trump. That should be the motto right now. It's time to get real. The shit is scary.
You've never been more wrong about anything. Yours is a selfish point of view. Yours is a selfish point of view. You don't know anything about what's going to happen in 2018. You're thinking about what's going to happen in 2018. What do you fucking know about it? You don't.
What the fuck do you know about it?
Don't talk to me like that. Don't talk to me like that fucking ever. We need to
put What did you just say to me?
I didn't say shut the fuck up.
All right, guys, let's go to break.
What do you fucking know about it?
Yeah, and that's incredibly awesome.
You just said it to me.
No, I wasn't. Break. I said you don't know what's going to happen in 2018.
Anna, the Chola's like, a break, break. Come on, guys, come on. This is classless. We don't want the Young Turks to be represented like this. Get the fuck off the stage, you fat fuck.
Get off the stage, you fat fuck. Get off.
Yeah, we don't want to come across as just a total band of idiots playing make-believe, playing newsman. I'm playing newsman.
That got us where we are
right
now.
You don't know anything about what's going to happen
in
2018. You're thinking we're going to come back.
What do you fucking know about it?
You don't.
What the fuck do you know about it?
And did you see Jimmy just fly off the handle? What the fuck do you know about it? To his boss. I mean, to the founder of the company. Can you imagine somebody like the president or the founder of CNN? He's getting interviewed and Anderson Cooper's like, yeah. What the fuck do you know about it? What the fuck do you know about it? And he spits in his face. I mean, this is just amazing. And Ben Mankiewicz is trying to explain to him that ideologically it makes zero sense to not vote for Hillary. But Jimmy can't accept defeat. Just like the Bernie or bust people cannot accept defeat. And yeah, go ahead and dislike this video. Go leave a comment. Oh, fuck this. Oh, I'm so upset. Go for that. I'm going to be wounded by that. Well done.
Don't talk to me like that. Don't talk to me like that fucking ever.
Yeah, don't talk to me like that fucking ever. Don't you ever. It reminds me of Boss Rutan, where he's in that video where he's teaching self-defense. Like if there's a fight that breaks out in a bar, this is what you're supposed to do. And he takes some guy's head and he's like, don't you ever do this again.
Create distance and grab a chair. You can slam it into his face. You can stab with it. And while I throw it at him, I will kick him in the groin, boom, right straight. Going to bounce his head on the table. 10 times or something. Don't you ever do this. Right away you say, okay, I'm sorry. Bang, bang, bang. No, I'm not.
Happened in 2018.
Bullshit.
You're thinking we're going to come back.
What do you fucking know about it?
You don't.
What the fuck do you know about it?
Don't talk to me like that. Don't talk to me like that fucking ever.
What did you just say to me?
I didn't say shut the fuck up.
All right, guys, let's go to break. Let's go to break.
What are you fucking?
Ben Mankiewicz is taking heat from all sides. Jimmy Dore disrespecting him, yelling in his face, what the fuck do you know about it? And it's because Ben Mankiewicz is the oldest and the smartest guy on the show. And the Jewiest. Coincidence? Nah. So Ben has to deal with Jimmy Dore's shit. He's got to deal with Genk freaking out and making a mockery of himself.
Pap smear.
Snatching the t-shirt away from Ben. He looks over at Anna. He puts his head down in shame. He's like, oh my God, this fucking little child. Why did we make this intern a fake anchor? Ben is in hell. He is in regressive hell. He reminds me of Neo at the beginning of The Matrix. He's going to work. He's working as some sort of software engineer. He comes home. He's sort of in a depressive state. He doesn't know why. He doesn't know what to do. He needs Morpheus. He needs to come out. Long live Hillary Clinton. All of you out there will bend the knee. I'm with her. We're doing this one way or another. And if Trump gets elected, guess what? I'm leaving the country and I'm going to Germany. Danke, tschüss.
Thanks for watching. That was the warm-up, of course, of the back muscles. So I'm going to get more specifically into the body parts in general. So you guys stick around, watch more videos by me. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them. And also, please, please rate my video and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to do that. And I'll see you guys next time. And also, please, please rate my video. Please rate my video.